It is alleged that the contract by which Jack Grynberg was given the stamp to explore for oil and gas around St. Lucian borders occurred during the St. Lucia Labour Party's tenure in office. Officials believe such a contract was dangerous as the island's seabed practically belonged to Mr. Grynberg. Minister Richard Frederick, seeking assistance from a former Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Energy in Grenada, is getting the island out of the deal.
We received quite a number of invitations from other developers who ask us to attempt to explore the waters to verify whether there is the existence of oil or natural gas within our territorial waters. And we, on investigation, we realized that this right, so to speak, had been taken away from the government and had been in the hands of Mr. Grynberg.
The former Grenada Deputy Prime Minister explained the challenges in getting out of such a deal, which cost Grenadian government over $10 million.
He knows that Grenada had put the foot down and had crushed his vicious activities worldwide. He tried the same thing in Israel with ministers abroad and governments elsewhere by this so-called a minister attempted to ask for a bribe. And as such, I said, getting such a person, not only because it redounds to the benefit of your people to remove a monopoly from all the waters, but from getting such a person out of getting the clause out of your country, I want to applaud you and I tell you that I will be there to give all the assistance that you have asked for.
Mr. Bowen said he's assisting in the interest of Caribbean unity, and according to Minister Frederick, plans are already on the way to get out of the situation.
We have tried desperately to ask him to relieve us of this onerous burden. We have secured the services of the very lawyers that Grenada secured in New York. We've had several meetings with them. I personally have met with them along with my Honorable Prime Minister, and you know, he does not want to get out of it, and essentially things are ongoing, and we suspect spending the kind of money that Grenada spent is the only way out, part of which we have already spent.
The Housing and Urban Renewal Minister says there's a lesson to be learned. The former Deputy Prime Minister of Grenada nevertheless complimented the current administration for taking steps to free the country from whom he described as an international fraudster. For the DBS News World, Jason Holland Seed reporting.